Just before discussing that newer emerging drugs, first we should discuss about types of drugs. So according to legality of drugs, we can divide it into two types of drugs, licit and illicit. Like in India, alcohol, tobacco and bhang is licit. All the others, most of the drugs are licit, and some of the drugs we don't know where they will fall. We'll discuss about that. So according to mechanism of action, if you see, largely, grossly, we can divide any kind of drug of abuse into three sections. One is stimulants, another is depressants, another is hallucinogens. We'll also consider antipsychotics, because which is just opposite of hallucinogens, and stimulant and depressants are the pole opposite. So now, as you can see, there are some overlaps. Some of the drugs like MDMA, mescaline, LSD, they have both stimulant as well as hallucinogenic properties. Whereas some of the other drugs like marijuana, having some stimulants activity, also may have some depressant activity. So largely, if you see, the stimulants drugs are psychotropic stimulants like amphetamine, cocaine, depressants are alcohol, other sedatives, and hallucinogens are some classical hallucinogens like LSD, DMT, ibogaine, etc. So yet another classification we'll try today. One is classic or traditional drugs like alcohol, heroin, cocaine. These drugs has been used throughout the history of mankind. So we know about these drugs. Government know about these drugs. Users know about these drugs. And most importantly, physicians also know about these drugs. But there are other classification, which is newer psychoactive substances, or which has been given a short name of NPS. Many of them are also known as designer drugs. So why designer? It is designed such that to escape the legal provisions. And we will consider these as emerging drugs. So these emerging drugs, which drugs will come under these things? One group will be the drugs which have only little or no history of any medical use, but discovered and used as recreational purpose. Like the example we can give, like some of the synthetic cannabinoids. Drugs used for medical purposes for many years back, but being used for recreational purpose in recent time. Like ketamine. Drugs used in specific region of the world as traditional use, but has been found to be used in many other parts in a recent time. So that this section also we'll discuss in the last. Drugs of addictive potential yet to be included in under any international or national controls, or has been included in those controls recently. With this background, as you can see, this is cannabis. Most of us know about it. Most of us know that it can be available as bhang, ganja, charas, hash oil, and how it is taken, oral or smoked. Also, we are aware of its psychological effects, like having dreamy state, perceptual sensory distortion, and if you are having bad trips, you will have fear, panic. 20% of cases may have that kind of experience also. But what is this? So as you can see, the name K2, spice, those things. So in internet, especially in darknet, these are sold as incense. These are sold as aromatic products or for other use. And in most of the cases, it will be written that not for human consumptions. But these are the synthetic marijuana, synthetic cannabis. These are actually not marijuana. Structurally also not that much related to marijuana, but has the capacity to have effects like marijuana, because it can bind to THC receptor, which is the main psychoactive receptor for marijuana. It was first invented in Clemson in the 1980s for research purposes. Now, why it becomes so much popular? Because it can give intense high, even more than cannabis. It's readily available in internet, online. It's affordable, and you can't detect in routine urine test. The effect of THC is also longer lasting, because many of these synthetic cannabinoids, metabolites are also active. So the effect will be long, and the receptor binding capacity affinity is also 4 to 10 times more. So that is, in one hand, may give a prolonged pleasure, in other hand, may be very dangerous. Again, I will emphasize on this fact. If you can have a one take-home message, just remind, I want to remind you that these things cannot be detected in urine screening. You will not find. The synthetic cannabis, after this popularization of the synthetic cannabis, there is a huge increase in emergency visit with synthetic cannabis intoxications. It may range from just agitated behavior, psychosis, anxiety, to seizure, rhabdomyolysis, hyperthermia. Even secondary to rhabdomyolysis, acute kidney injury may be there. Some reports of myocardial ischemia infections also have been there. And another very important part is that there is no antidote for any of this and cannot be detected. And in mild cases, benzodiazepine may be sufficient. But in severe cases, only supportive care we have to do, give. And ICU setup is mandatory to treat this kind of intoxications. Next, we'll move on to this substance. As you can see, this is a opium pod. So this has been also used throughout the history of mankind. And two words happened based on this. And heroin is one of the product from morphine, which is from opioid. This we know about heroin, large amount of it, because injectable use of heroin and its complications and overdose, along with that, we have also have quite advancement in treatment of heroin and this kind of naturally occurring opioid or semi-synthetic opioid dependence. But now in USA, if you see, there is a crisis which is not entirely on heroin. Heroin is there, but at the same time, another player came into the field, which is synthetic opioid. Within the last 5 years, there are 34 synthetic opioids have been detected, seized, or found in the blood, drug test of illicitly seized drug. 26 of them are fentanyl analogs, and these are acetyl fentanyl, oxfentanyl, butyl fentanyl, all those things. And they have differential potency towards mu receptors. And this non-medical use, if you see, the self-report of non-medical use of fentanyl is very less, 0.1%. But that is not our concern. Our main concern is illicit fentanyl analogs. Actually, these drugs has been mixed with heroin. Also mixed with ecstasy and sold as counterfeit prescription opioids. This is our main worry. And many of the unaware users are suffering from fatal overdose because of that. And actually, within the past year, there is doubled number of death because of this fentanyl epidemics in USA. So what is fentanyl? Fentanyl is synthetic opioid analgesic. 100 times more potent than morphine, very rapid high, very good barrier permeability, and it can be available as powder, spiked on bulletin paper, and then mixed with or substituted for heroin, all those things. And fentanyl was binding in opioid receptor and have the similar effect like morphine, euphoria, drowsiness, nausea, confusion, and have similar dreadful effect like morphine or heroin, like cardiac, like respiratory arrest, coma, and death. Now, next, like if you see in India, this fentanyl, all those things are not that much reported, but we have our own fentanyl, that is tramadol and tapentadol. So, from our center itself, there are two reports, as you can see, that whether tapentadol is a potential Trojan horse for post dextromethorphan era. So we don't know, because nowadays, within the last few months itself, all of us are getting many patients who are actually abusing or dependent on tapentadol. So these are also synthetic opioids, and apart from mu receptor, they are also having monoamine. Pardon me, this will be reuptake inhibitor, monoamine reuptake inhibitors. So activity, and mainly they were marketed of having less addictive potential, but the post surveillance data proves otherwise. Now, just one information I will give. Almost 50 lakhs tramadol capsule has been seized in Ghana, and 40% of them having that each capsule is containing almost 120 milligram of tramadol, and almost 20% containing 225 milligram of tramadol. As we all know that actually it's marketed as 50 to 100 milligram. So each capsule is containing much more quantity than actually it's decided by any control group. And of these tramadol, 87% of them has been seized from, whatever has been seized are originated from India. So there are clandestine revolutionaries in India who are producing these things and actually are smuggling it outside. So we don't know where our Indian market will be under their influence. Next is cocaine. As you can see, these are plant product. Again, it has been used for many years in South America. But now this synthetic analog of this cocaine is amphetamine type stimulant, also known as ATS. It can be classified under this amphetamine, methamphetamine in other derivatives, and cathinone will come under this section, methylphenidate, and ephedrine, pseudoephedrine. Those are actually precursor of amphetamine, methamphetamine. So this mephedrone, meamaw, will come under this cathinone group. So it is available as tablets. In Southeast Asia, it's popularly known as yaba. Also, it's available as methamphetamine is available as crystals. So this methamphetamine crystal in that down picture, as you can see. So few years, if you see the data 10 years back, only the major drug marketing, all those things were there in Mexico, in American region. But now this has been a major issue in Southeast and Eastern Asia, and gradually these waves are spreading towards India and also in the Middle East, as you can see in this picture. This is from World Drug Report 2018. And in Southeastern, South Asia, UNODC report also, they have found that alarmingly this ATS is emerging in our country. So they have also reported that the new epidemics, apart from the Northeast, new epidemics are there in Punjab, Haryana, and Rajasthan. And another important issue is ATS-induced psychosis. Predominantly hallucination, delusions is there. And many of them used to report formication, which is some kind of tactile hallucinations. And it can occur during intoxications, and even after intoxications also it can persist. With delirium, without delirium, this psychosis can persist. Now, so some of the risk factors are binge use, prolonged use, all of a sudden increase of the amount of use, sleep deprivation, and some psychological vulnerability, as well as some genetic or familial vulnerability. So apart from that, just one line I'll add with this. Not only the psychosis and psychological symptoms, these ATS stimulants are very much dangerous during intoxications because they can cause hypertension, they can cause cardiac arrhythmias, they can cause acute renal injuries, they can cause hemorrhagic strokes. Okay, so all these things because of the sympathomimetic activity of these stimulants. Next, we'll move on to ketamine. This is another emerging drug. It has been used as in veterinary and also in human as anesthetic agents. But at present, it's of more of like recreational use in many parts. And the acute experience that they used to describe is emergence phenomena. In very low dose, it may act as stimulant, but gradually as the dose increases, the sense of melting into people or things that empathogenic activity, then distortion of perception, derealization, depersonalization, as well as hallucinations also may be there. And another experience that they have reported is K-hole. As you can see, that there is if there is a large dose of cannabis has been used, the feeling of complete sensory detachment or near-death experience may be there in this case. So some of the negative psychological potential fatal effect may be like respiratory depressions, also hemorrhagic cystitis also have been reported with ketamine, along with that loss of coordination, impaired memory, all those things also have been described. So this is the quantity of ketamine seized globally. As you can see, it's persisted throughout this from 2012 to 2016. And there is mild decrease from 2015 to 2016. And most of the region that is involved is your southeastern and East Asia. So as we have almost discussed some of the synthetic psychoactive, newer psychoactive substances, this is the, again, World Drug Report. As you can see, there is consistent increase of types or variety of synthetic substances throughout, that has been reported throughout these years. In 2016, it was 479 types, and most of them are from synthetic cannabinoid followed by synthetic cannabinoids group. India is also involved into all those things like ketamine, seizures. As you can see from this report, I will not go into detail. So many of these synthetic drugs also has been throughout this India in some of the parts. Next, as we have already discussed about synthetic, now hand in hand, these are also there. These substances are naturally occurring, plant-based, but new psychoactive substances, because traditionally in some of the region they were used, but now it has been used throughout the globe. And one of that is, as you can see, is kratom. It came into picture from 2014 and gradually it increased in 2016. And another was kut. It was there in 2012 and it persisted. So first, briefly, we will discuss about kratom. This is the plant. The main psychoactive substance is mitragynine and alpha hydroxymitragynine. In large dose, it acts like opioid, but in small dose, it acts like stimulants. And most of the health effects are related to opioid-like symptoms. There are some controversy regarding medical use, but there is no data to support that. Most of the data support the addictive potential of kratom. And kratom has been identified in blood or urine sample of 44 overdose death. So that's why in 2017 FDA issued series of warning. So now this is cut. As you can see, Ethiopian jersey. So it was traditionally used in Eastern Africa and Arabian Peninsula, but now it has been used throughout the Europe and also America. And to delay the decay, it is dried and then transported. Without doing that, it will not have any psychoactive use after 48 hours of harvesting. Now, just I will summarize whatever we have discussed. Like earlier, whatever drugs that are used, public know about it. Physicians know about it, government know about it. But now most of these synthetic drugs or plant-based drugs, these are mostly elusive and they are giving legal highs, because legally you can't detain. And many of them are easily available in internet. So the youth, the adolescents, they are very much vulnerable for this kind of drugs. Notoriously difficult to predict which kind of effect one will have after modification of any of these chemicals, because these are designer drugs. And regarding some of the plant products like kratom, There are some misperceptions that these products are natural, that's why harmless. It's not true. And the same reason of lack of knowledge, the drug effects and treatment are also not clear. So what will be our take-home message? Historically, the drugs are derived from plants, but now the situation is a bit different because of our improved knowledge of neurochemistry. And there is growing problems, especially in some of the vulnerable population like adolescent and youth. It often can lead to acute behavioral disturbances. And knowledge and vigilance is very important in every step of our society, starting from international bodies, from national bodies, from physicians, from family members, parents, and also from individual perspective. Thank you.